action, and we're just about set to kick off. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. UCLA has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 24. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Quick strike to the receiver, and he's shoved out of bounds at about the 33-yard line. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Throwing right.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
They'll bring him down around the 45-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Looks middle, got his back, and he's taken down at the 47-yard line. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Now he's scrambling. And they got him.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
Down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Going deep, lays it out there. Tackle at the 17.
Here's a great example of what this man is capable of. As receivers go, he's as electric as they come.
The stop right around the 2-yard line.
That's another first down, Brad. And right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs is pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
Touchdown, Marshall! Tacks on the extra point. A 9-play, 76-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Quick throw. Tackle made around the 37-yard line. Throws and it's incomplete.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
From their own 37-yard line. Second down. scrambles. And he dives forward. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers.
Number seven was his intended receiver on the play.
From midfield, second down. They come out on an empty backfield. And he's immediately tackled. Fights forward to about the 39. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
He's at the 30, and down he goes at the 23. Taken down at the 14. They run it left. He's tackled at the 6-yard line. Try running left. Brought down at the 3-yard line.
Gain of 3 yards. That brings up second and goal.
They're at the 3. It's second down. Touchdown, Bruins. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. It was a 12-play, 76-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
We're even at 7 in this one. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. Well, the offense heading back out onto the field after that kick, hoping to turn this drive into another touchdown.
And it was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. It's second and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. Tackled at the 35-yard line. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 35. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. He's on the run, got the corner. They bring him down. And they're going to put 6 DBs on the field to counter that 5 receiver look. It fly. Picked off. Shakes off a tackle. He came up with a fantastic interception there.
Well, you know the quarterback is kicking himself for that one. He just made the wrong read.
First and 10, ball on the 47. Makes it out to about the 39. Takes the ball inside. Gains his way to the 30-yard line. He's at the 20, and he's level at the 19-yard line. The 10, the 5, and that sets them up for the first and goal.
Good solid running right there. Getting past the defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
Touchdown, UCLA! Short burst for the score.
That's what happens when you can win the war in the trenches down near the goal line.
And he converts the extra point. The scoreboard lit up in that first 15 minutes. The Bruins in front, 14-7. UCLA ready to kick this one off.
Number 7 sets in turn.
He's out to the 30. He makes it to the 32-yard line. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
Each possession gets more and more vital as the game goes on, especially when you're behind. You can't afford to make many more mistakes.
They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line. Down, and he's taken down around the 42-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Makes the catch, and look out. He's at the 20. And he tackles him hard at the 14-yard line. The tight end came up with a nice catch that time.
Yeah, the big fella's pretty athletic for a tight end. And as a quarterback, it's always nice to have a big target like this to go to.
Hands it off on the delay. Gets to about the 14-yard line. Nothing doing on the halfback draw.
That'll bring up second and 11.
Here's the halfback on the screen. That's a great tackle at the 15-yard line. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. First and goal from the 2, and they can smell the end zone. They're packed in tight on the line. Touchdown, Thundering Herd.
These blocking packs do a lot of dirty work during the game, so it's good to reward them. kind of barrel it in for a score once in a while.
So they had their chances to stop him, but in the end, he comes up with a big play.
He makes the PAT.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 26. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. He fights forward to about the 29. He's scrambling. Tackle at the 29. Scrambling around. And he's sacked.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out of practice, they told us there were some big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against him, maybe get the ball out of the pocket a little bit quicker, maybe use running backs and tight ends to help with double teams on the outside. But right now, whatever they thought they might be able to do, they better get back to that drawing board because these defensive ends are just too quick.
And that's three and out. Nothing going on that series. It's a short kick. They'll bring him down at the 48. And as the defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around.
If you can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
He's going to go for the home run.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 48. Quick throw to the tight end. Well, the defense stood tall there.
Well, the defense did what they had to do to get three and out and now get the offense back on the field.
He's going to try to coffin corner this one. Here's the punt. No, they're going to throw it. Incomplete. Huge play for the defense. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. He steps out right around the 42-yard line.
That screen play was well executed. I'm not sure the defense was looking for it, and they weren't in great position to make a play until the first down was already picked up.
Is out to the tailback on the screen. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. They're stopped 2 yards behind the line.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
Strike to his receiver. No good.
Brad, this is a good job by this defense of getting after the quarterback. And until this offense finds a way to slow down that pressure, if I'm the defensive coordinator, I continue to dial up the blitz.
A screen pass, gets it to the back. Excellent open field tackle. That was a good pass and catch there, but still not enough for the first down.
That's not an easy conversion here on third down for the offense. All the defense has to do is stay back, keep everything in front of them, come up and make a tackle. Oklahoma.
direct strike to the receiver, and he hits him hard at the 21-yard line. The Bruins use their second timeout. From the 21-yard line, it's first down. Give to the tailback, and they got him for a loss. Now he tries to buy some time, and they got him.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
And they push him out around the 13-yard line. Fourth down, they're going to go for the easy three here. UCLA could take the lead with this field goal. It's up, and the field goal is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He got hit hard. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. He's going to air it long. Incomplete. We've still got a half of football remaining. UCLA's got a three-point lead.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. The stats are certainly not overwhelming from an offensive standpoint. These two teams averaging less than 6 yards per pass attempt. That's not really what you're after in the passing game. But a lot of it can be attributed to really good defense. Look, you know quarterbacks want to take care of the ball first, but they also want to push it down the field. How do you balance that with this guy? Not a lot of room downfield to throw the ball, it doesn't seem, but he's taking the check down pretty quick.
Yeah, well, and if there is no room down the field, and you don't see very many open receivers just streaking. I mean, you haven't seen that. So the defense is doing a good job of taking that deep stuff away. But the number one thing is, if you're going to bail out Reese and you give him that underneath stuff, that easy pass completion, you got to tackle. And that's what they're doing. They're coming up and they're not letting him, you know, throw a 7-yard route that goes 50 yards. And that's one of the biggest keys to defense. Let him throw the underneath stuff, come up, make a good tackle, live to fight another down.
You know, I had a wise coach once tell me, teams do not beat you throwing and catching. They beat you by running after the catch. We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Tackle made at the 31-yard line. Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. UCLA holds a field goal lead. Tackle made at the 28-yard line. Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 28. On the ground with the tailback. Gains his way to the 39-yard line. Hit immediately. That makes it first and 10. Throws it in a hurry. And they make the stop at the 27. First down. tackled after positive yardage. Brought down at the 25-yard line. Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Boy, what great play recognition by this linebacker. He saw the run was coming, and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 17. Flips it, middle to the running back. He's tackled at the 25. We've got a change at the quarterback position. Got to wonder how that's going to affect this offense. I would think the offensive coordinator and the head coach are just going to try to ease him into this game at the beginning. UCLA is up a field goal. Trying to get it to the tight end, but it falls to the ground. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And down he goes, right around the 32-yard line. Field for a loss.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff. Great job here in shutting down the run. That's a real boost for this team.
Get all of that one. He drops it. And down he goes at the 43. So they're just about set to get the game going again. He airs it out. Doesn't get there. He let that pass get away from him.
I think he's a little bit anxious. He actually looked a little bit too juiced that time, but he'll get the next one.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 43. UCLA is up by three. He's taken down at the 46-yard line. Shot to the tight end, and he can't pull it in.
That makes it second and 10.
Gets it out quickly. And he's tackled at the 40-yard line.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. Third down.
Gets him open field. Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
From the 30-yard line, it's second down. And he's level at the 22.
Number 28 makes the tackle at the 22-yard line. That'll bring up third and 2.
Fires that quickly, incomplete. So they're going to go for it here. You don't need three guesses to figure out what they're going to run right here on fourth and short. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
Not sure about that play call as they fail on fourth down.
Yeah, they went with a toss play here, but no one on that defensive side of the ball was fooled. You got to give them credit for making a great play.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. They'll bring him down at the 38-yard line. Incomplete.
I know this quarterback trusts his arm and his receivers, but he's got to know when not to throw the ball. He didn't have any room at all, and he's lucky it wasn't intercepted.
It's third down and six to go. All on their own 42. He goes downtown. Can't connect. He led his wide receiver too far to the outside.
Yeah, he just had to pull the string a little bit more there.
Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. It's away. Short punt. Marshall's a team that nobody gave a chance today, but they're right where they want to be.
I think just the mindset of this football team, they need to be complimented for that, because it's easy to come in, be a bit intimidated, be a bit overwhelmed. They've put that to the side, gone out and executed, and I think the longer they've stayed in this game, the more confidence that it's instilled.
Taken down at the 46. UCLA has a three-point lead. And they get nice yardage on that run. Makes it out to about the 30. They'll get him for a loss. Tight, folks. We head to the fourth quarter in what could be a shocker. The Bruins with a three-point lead. Well, this final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. Open field, and he tackles him hard at the 14. Tackle at about the 13. Play of this drive. UCLA holds a field goal lead. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. That makes it 4th and 9.
after the sack. It's now fourth and long. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
Unbelievable pass. They don't care what down it is.
Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
From the 1 yard line, second down. Touchdown, Bruins. And he hits the PAT. So an 11-play, 67-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He's out to the 30. He's taken down at the 33. UCLA's defense has really been impressive, especially these last couple of drives.
Well, now you start to think about how this team has played defensively, and what it's done is set up their own offense with really good field position to give them a chance to be able to extend this lead.
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. And he is drilled at the 41. To his receiver in a hurry. Tackle made around the 46-yard line. And they get the sack.
Man, if an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see. Is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
Looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. He's going to try and scramble, and he's going to be sacked.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
Just under 3 to go in regulation. Going deep, lays it out there. No, incomplete.
He was a little erratic on that pass, but there's no denying that he can really hum it in there.
The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. And he can't hang on to the ball. And he's taken down at the 39. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Hands it off. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Second and 9 coming up here. Ball on their own 40. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. He keeps it and picks up maybe a yard.
Good job by the junior linebacker to read the run and limit the play to a short game.
Blue 19. Big opening. Nice run, and he's brought down. They had to gain, and they'll end up a foot or two shy.
Yeah, the defense closed up that hole just in time.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. It's a short kick. Tackle at the 31. Time's running out now as the offense comes back out.
They need to score here, then recover an onside kick and score again. Although this game isn't over yet, I just don't think they can accomplish that feat with this much time left in the game.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. He wants it all. Incomplete.
They got lucky on that play. That receiver was wide open, but the quarterback just missed him.
From their own 31-yard line, it's second down. Throws quick to the receiver and it falls incomplete.
Brad, I don't know about you, but it looks to me that they just miscommunicated. It looked like the wide receiver was going in one direction and the quarterback was throwing it another direction. They definitely need to get on the same page.
Over the middle to his tailback. Can't wrap him up. And they make the stop at the 42. Immediately tackled.
Very solid game through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
Spikes the ball. That makes it third and three. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. He lets it go. Hits him hard at the 33-yard line.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
And he stops the clock with a spike. Well, they'll line it up again on third down. Two for two so far on this drive. Under a minute left. Steps up in the pocket. This one's going deep to the end zone.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
He heaves it to the end zone.
When the first down marker is that far away, someone's got to step up and make a play on fourth down. It just didn't happen for him here.
You aren't going to convert many fourth downs against this defense. That's a really good stop. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. From their own 30-yard line, second down. And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had.
Hey, I'm going to run you over. I'm going to run you over.
Hey, check my 46. Check my 46.
Check. Eight, Bruins.
And so that's going to do it. The Bruins take this one. 24-14. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.